Hello children, in this lecture we will discuss reducing action of ammonia gas, its test and its uses. So first we will start from reducing action of ammonia gas. So as you can see here that ammonia reduces heated metallic oxides to metals. So in this reaction ammonia will behaves as a reducing agent. Now reactants, we will take copper 2 oxide only. This time you are having only copper 2 oxide in your syllabus. So reactants, you will take copper 2 oxide and ammonia. And the products will be formed as reduced products. As a reduced product, copper and water and nitrogen. Okay, students. So as a reduced product, copper will form plus water and nitrogen will be formed. Now procedure, dry ammonia gas is passed over heated black copper 2 oxide. Placed in a combustion tube A. Now observation, black copper 2 oxide is reduced to pink copper. So instead of brown, it should be pink. So just change the color of the copper, pink copper metal. Okay, students. So your observation will be black copper 2 oxide will be reduced to pink copper. Okay, so just nitrogen gas is collected in the gas jar. So this is regarding this reducing nature of ammonia. The equation is given here. So this is the most important equation part. Ammonia when reacts with basic oxide, which is copper oxide here, is forming copper metal, which is a reduced product, and pink in color, plus water plus nitrogen. So only this reaction is in the syllabus. Reaction, its conditions and reactants observation, all these things. Then B heading, ammonia reduces chlorine to hydrogen chloride. When ammonia and chlorine are mixed, the chlorine is reduced to HCl, which further combines with excess ammonia forming NH4Cl. Okay, students. So first, ammonia is reducing chlorine in the form of HCl. But in the presence of excess amount of ammonia, the last product will be ammonium chloride. So ammonia in excess, what will be the last product? Ammonium chloride. So first, ammonia will reduce chlorine in hydrogen chloride, and in excess amount of ammonia, this hydrogen chloride will be again changed to ammonium chloride. So overall, the product will form is ammonium chloride and nitrogen in excess supply of ammonia. So dense white fumes are the seen when NH3 reacts with HCl and also when it reacts with Cl2. Okay, so just so NH3 with HCl forming dense white fumes of ammonium chloride. So these are dense white fumes. Okay, so just so what will happen when we will pass excess amount of ammonia in chlorine? So what you will observe? You will observe dense white fumes formation, and this compound will be ammonium chloride. Then chlorine in excess. Now when chlorine is present in excess amount, then NCl3 nitrogen trichloride will form. So with HCl, NCl3 will form, and this NCl3 is a green, yellow explosive liquid. Okay, so NCl3 is a yellow explosive liquid, and Cl2 is a greenish yellow gas. So a greenish yellow gas, when reacting with a colorless basic gas, forming a liquid of yellow color plus hydrogen chloride gas. Okay, students. So after this, next page. Test of ammonia. So as you all know that pungent odor gas, action of indicator, red litmus turns blue, methyl orange from orange to yellow, and phenolphthalein from colorless to pink. So the first one is the most important. Then next test is a very common test for ammonia and also for HCl gas. HCl gas. Okay, students. So what we do here, we take a glass rod. We take a glass rod dipped in concentrated HCl at the mouth of the gas jar, which is filled with ammonia gas. So a dense white fumes of NH4Cl are formed. Okay, students. So ammonia reacts with fumes of HCl and forming dense white fumes of ammonium chloride. So a glass rod dipped in concentrated HCl brought near ammonia gas. Then you will observe dense white fumes of ammonium chloride. By passage of ammonia gas through copper sulfate solution. So first, pale blue PPT of copper hydroxide is formed. And when you pass excess amount of ammonium hydroxide solution, so deep blue colored solution will form. Okay, students, and deep blue color solution is due to the formation of this complex compound. Okay, so in limited presence of limited supply of ammonium hydroxide or ammonia gas in aqueous solution of copper sulfate, you will get pale blue PPT of copper hydroxide, and in excess amount of NH4OH or excess amount of ammonia in CuSO4, then finally you will get deep blue colored solution due to the formation of this complex compound. Okay, students, with Nestler's reagent, ammonia gives pale brown PPT. Pale brown PPT. Okay, so colorless Nestler's reagent turns pale brown with ammonia gas. Okay, or passage of ammonia form a brown precipitate. Okay, students, so this is the test of ammonia gas. The next page, uses of ammonia. In uses of ammonia, you are having first fertilizers. So all these fertilizers are there. Urea, formalized NH2CONH2, ammonium sulfate, ammonium nitrate, NH4NO3, calcium ammonium nitrate, then diammonium hydrogen phosphate. These all are the names of fertilizers. Okay, so ammonia gas is used in the manufacture of fertilizers and also used in the manufacture of nitric acid and explosives. So one example of an explosive is ammonium nitrate. So these two uses and one this use, fertilizer formation. Then liquor ammonia, use of liquor ammonia. It is used as a cleansing agent. So liquor ammonia emulsifies or dissolves fat, grease, etc. So liquor ammonia acts as emulsifier or dissolver of fats or grease. That is why it acts as cleansing agent. Hence is used for removing oil or grease stains from clothes. The liquor ammonia is also used for cleansing window pans, porcelain articles, etc. So this point is very important here. Then liquid ammonia. Liquid ammonia. Ammonia gas liquefied at low temperature. So liquid ammonia is used as refrigerant in ice plants. Is used as refrigerant since it is highly volatile, has a high latent heat of evaporation and easily liquefies. So these three are the reasons why we are using ammonia gas as a refrigerant in ice plants. If therefore liquid ammonia is evaporated, a relatively large amount of heat is obtained, absorbed from the surroundings, and the water is converted to ice. So due to high latent heat of evaporation, when ammonia gases get evaporated, then it takes a lot of heat from its surrounding, and that is why the water is converted to ice. So this is the reaction here. Heat of evaporation of ammonia is 5.7 kilocalories at minus 33 degrees Celsius. Okay students, so this is the reason. Due to high latent heat of evaporation, ammonia acts as freezing, refrigerating gas. The next heading is chlorofluorocarbons in refrigeration gas cause ozone depletion. So chlorofluorocarbons, CFC, that is CFCl3, freon. So CFCl3 is an example of chlorofluorocarbon. Are chemicals which, like liquefied ammonia gas, are used in refrigeration gas. Unlike liquid ammonia, chlorofluorocarbons enter the atmosphere due to their excessive use as coolants in refrigeration and AC plants, aerosol sprays and cleansing agents. They cause ozone depletion in the atmosphere. So this is a very dangerous drawback of chlorofluorocarbons. They are causing ozone depletion. Okay students, so what is this ozone layer? Ozone layer is a layer of ozone located in the stratosphere above the earth. So chlorofluorocarbons are decomposed by ultraviolet rays to give free Cl radicals, and these radicals catalyze the depletion reaction of ozone. These free radicals of chlorine catalyzes the depletion reaction of ozone. So chlorofluorocarbon forming Cl atom. This Cl atom breaks the ozone layer, causing ozone depletion. So ozone with Cl is forming ClO plus O2. So the ozone layer, which prevents harmful ultraviolet radiations from reaching the earth, and endangering human and plant life, gets depleted. Okay, so due to this action of chlorofluorocarbons, ozone depletion, the ozone layer, which prevents harmful ultraviolet radiations, get depleted. Okay students, suitable alternatives to chlorofluorocarbons which are non-ozone depleting are, they include hydrochlorofluorocarbons, HCFC, which act as substitute for chlorofluorocarbons. Okay, so HCFC are the substitute of chlorofluorocarbons. The hydrochlorofluorocarbons include 1,2,3 HCFC 1,2,3, that is 2,2-dichloro-1,1-trifluoroethane. So this is the IUPAC name of this particular hydrochlorofluorocarbon. And the second one is HCFC 1,2,4, and the IUPAC name of this compound is this. Okay students, the last, the hydrofluorocarbon include HFC-125, which is pentafluoroethane. So HFC-125, IUPAC name is pentafluoroethane. So instead of use of chlorofluorocarbons, we can use hydrochlorofluorocarbons, which are not cause ozone depletion in atmosphere. Okay, students. So this much for today in this lecture. You solve all the questions which are given in your book. Thank you.